Actually, two. I had a leak. And I was smelling oil, the smell of oil inside of the cabin. I thought it was, when I installed my valve cover gaskets, that I didn't tighten them down enough. So I removed the coil packs and went around the boat on the valve covers on both sides and tightened them down, which they were fine. Later on, I'm still smelling oil. I was checking my oil dipstick, something I normally would do every now and then. My dipstick was dry. I thought, oh no. I looked under my vehicle. And there's this wet spot on my exhaust pipe and under my oil pan. Everything looks wet. And I'm wondering, why does this look red and some of it looks brown? I'm assuming, well, my transmission cooler lines, my oil cooler lines, something's going on. When I looked at this all around where this block is, it was really wet. I took a rag and dried it off. I watched a few videos and people were having the same issues with their SUVs. I was told on one video that if you replace the gasket, that should stop the leak in this area. Seemed like it was just coming from this area here. I went to find a new gasket. I drove around a few places. They didn't have it. They told me they had to order it. I didn't want to order. So I would go to another store. We don't have that. We gotta order it. I came home, took my gasket out, cleaned it up, put some gasket maker on it, and reinstalled it. I added some more oil, and I drove, and I was monitoring this for a day, and the oil stayed. The dipstick was fine. But there was still a small leak. So I'm thinking, well, either I really need that gasket or something's going on with the lines. I followed the lines all the way up to the front of the vehicle. And you can see where they were wet around the rubber part of it. So I went and got me a whole new line. And this is just the oil cooler lines that run from the side of the oil pan. The area of the oil pan up to the radiator. I think it's over $80. I heard that I'm gonna have to drain my oil, take off my oil filter, I'm gonna have to disconnect the front of my drive shaft. And I'm just lower it. I'm gonna have to lower my front differential just enough so this can slide through and back with ease. A couple of hours, from what I've heard. Without doing that, I heard you can do it, but you're gonna end up bending some stuff and it's gonna be frustrating and it may take 5 hours. That's phase one, getting my oil cooler lines on.
So this cap just pops off with a flathead screwdriver. Okay. Look like the rear seal is fine. I don't see any leaks there. And I can look around in there. It looks dry to me.